Welcome to this introductory video on Markdown, where I show you how working in plain text can make your academic writing easier. In this video, I'm going to cover the following topics. First, I'm going to give you a definition of what Markdown is, and then I'll talk about the advantages of working in Markdown, both in general and then specifically for academics. And after that, I'll do a live example of academic writing in Markdown. In fact, if you want to skip right to the action, you can just forward the video. And then finally, I'll end with some recommendations for those of you who are interested in pursuing Markdown further. So, what is Markdown? On an abstract level, we could say that Markdown is a way to simplify writing in the digital age, where we have to publish the same text in multiple forms and where we rarely have to print things out. On a more concrete level, though, Markdown is a syntax that allows you to incorporate rich text elements into plain text documents. Now, there's a lot of jargon in that definition, so let me unpack some of those terms. First, what is rich text? So you know when you open up a Microsoft Word document and you can see all the formatting features in the text? You know, the words you want to be bold are bold, the words that you want to be italicized appear in italics, and then there are other elements. There are footnotes, section titles, different kinds of fonts, sizes, colors. Those are all features that you can see in a rich text document. Now, in contrast, a plain text document has none of those features. All you have letters, numbers, punctuation marks, and then other symbols. You don't have any of the formatting elements that you can include in a rich text document. And all of this then brings us to syntax. And syntax is a system for using symbols and characters to explain to your computer how you want certain things done, or in this case, how you want your text to look. For example, if I'm writing in plain text and I want a word to appear as bold, I can't simply highlight it and then hit Control B like I do in Microsoft Word. So I use a certain syntax to represent it. In Markdown, that just means that I put asterisks on either side of the word that I want to be bold. So, now what are some of the general advantages of writing in Markdown? First and foremost, it makes you focus on your writing and keeps you from getting distracted by formatting. And I don't know about you, but like when I have a writing project and I'm working in Microsoft Word, I spend a lot of time making sure that the headers look the way I want them to look, picking the font that I want to use, you know, generally fiddling with the formatting as a way to procrastinate. But when I'm writing in Markdown, I don't have any of those excuses. I have to, you know, write. Another advantage of Markdown is that it can easily be exported to multiple formats. So I can write a document in Markdown and then convert it into HTML for publishing on a website or to a PDF for printing, or even a Word document if the person I'm working with, you know, just has to have it in Microsoft Word. And while Markdown allows you to export to all these different formats, the actual text file that you're working in is basically future-proof. I mean, have you ever wanted to access some writing that you did a decade ago in WordPerfect? Or maybe you have a bunch of writing you did in Pages, Apple Pages, before they changed the format and now you can't open those files? Or maybe, you know, what'll happen if people stop using Microsoft Word? What'll happen to those files? Or maybe you just don't, like, you know, want to pay Microsoft Word for their license? You know, none of this is a worry if you're working in plain text. It's the same as it was decades ago, and it will continue to be the same decades from now. And the final advantage of plain text documents is that they're small, easy to move from one device to another, and easy for many different programs to read. This means that you can start a document in your computer, and then you can work on it in your iPad or even on your phone, and you don't need to worry about taking up lots of memory or having compatibility issues. And all of these features that I just mentioned, they're going to be helpful to academic writers, but there are two additional benefits that I think will be especially helpful. The first is that Markdown makes collaboration easy. Have you ever been working with a team on an article or a long report, and you all have like formatting conflict issues, like one person wants Microsoft Word, another person is using Google Docs, the third person is using Microsoft Word but with a template that they really like? You know, none of this is an issue when you're writing in plain text. You just assemble all of the pieces and then everything is uniform and formatted consistently. And then the second benefit is that in the particular flavor of Markdown that I am using called Pandoc, all the references are auto-generated for you. So it doesn't matter if one person is using Chicago, another person likes APA. Again, Markdown takes care of all of that for you. In fact, you know, even if you're writing just for yourself, it's helpful to not have to worry about all the citations being correct. You just let Markdown take care of it. So that's what I have to say about the benefits of Markdown. Now let's move to the demonstration part of this video. Before I do, though, let me point out a few things. On the next screen, the left side is going to have a white background, and that's where I'll be writing in plain text. The right side of the screen is where the final formatted text will appear. It represents how your text might look if it were published on a website. I've made it yellow and added some other contrasting colors to make it stand apart from the plain text side of the screen. Remember that you can always adjust the colors and formatting as you see fit. Also, because this is more of a demonstration video than a how-to video, I'm going to move pretty quickly through the features of writing Markdown. My objective is to give you an idea of how Markdown works so that you can then go off and explore it further on your own. So with all of that in mind, let's get started. So here we are in the demonstration screen, and again, the plain text is on the left and the preview is on the right. The first thing I'm going to do is add a title to this document. And the way you do that is in the first line of the document, you start with the percent sign, and then you add your title. And if you want to add the author, you use another percent sign in the next line. And you can even add the date. Of course, most academic writing also needs sections, so let's add those too. The way you do that, and I'll go to a new line, is you use a hash tag. And if I wanted to add a subsection, instead of using one hashtag, I would use two. Once you have the document structure in place, you can start writing. And in Markdown, you simply separate your paragraphs by one blank line. So it might look something like this. Now, if I wanted my words to be in bold or italics, I would simply put asterisks around the part that I wanted to be in italic or bold. So for italics, I use one asterisk on either side. And if I wanted it to be bold, I would use two asterisks. Now let's say in this first paragraph, I wanted to include a list. How would I do that? Well, I would start a new line. I'll make my list items here. And if I wanted this to be a bulleted list, I would just add asterisks and a space before each item. If instead of a bulleted list, I wanted a numbered list, I would replace it with, you guessed it, numbers. Another thing you might want in your academic writing is a block quote for long citations. This is very easy in Markdown. All you do is you add a more than sign and a space. Something else that might be useful are footnotes. And to do that, you just use a square bracket, a caret symbol, the shorthand you want for your note, then you close the square brackets. And then at the bottom of the document, actually anywhere in the document, you repeat the same syntax with a colon and then the note. And you can see in the preview, the number's right here. If I click on it, it'll take me down to the bottom, and then I can click on the back arrow to take me back. Let's say that instead of a numbered list, I actually wanted to use a table. Well, in Markdown, I would use a series of pipes and dashes to create that table, and it would look something like this. If I wanted to add a caption, I would just add it below. And now we're going to get to the good part, the part where Markdown really earns its keep for academic writing, and that's in citations. So let's start with the block quote. Let's say I want to add a parenthetical citation at the end of that block quote. Well, the way I would do it is I would use the at symbol and then a citation key. So let me get the citation key. You can see that the citation key has been added here. I'll put it in square brackets and watch as it appears on the other side. Now this is in Chicago format. And in addition to parenthetical citations, I can also do in-text citations. So in fact, if we go to the first paragraph, let me just copy and paste this same one. You can see that I have the author name and year. And then if I scroll to the end of this document, you can see that the full reference has been added. So that's a quick rundown of academic writing in Markdown, how you can add title, author, date, sections, paragraphs, bold and italic words, add lists, also block quotes, footnotes, tables, and references. And I hope what comes across is just how simple these syntax rules are and what a big payoff you can get in the long term in your own academic writing. So that's it for this video on academic writing in Markdown. If you like the video, please click like below. If you want more, please subscribe, and also, you know, leave me your comments in the comment section. Also, let me end with a few recommendations. If you want to pursue Markdown further, the first resource I would recommend is the Markdown Field Guide by David Sparks and Eddie Smith. The second one I would recommend is going to the PanDoc website. There's a lot of tutorials and very, you know, comprehensive instructions on using this version of Markdown. And then finally, I recommend David Smith's blog, which has some great tips for starting to use Markdown if you're an academic writer. And the links to all of these resources are in the description for this video. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching and take care.